Luke Burbank has been shopping for status symbols to die for.
You can immediately feel like when you go into a nice neighborhood, you're like, you get that feeling like, wow, the trees are nice. Everybody has manicured lawns.
Uh-huh. What's the $150,000 get me?
Great waterfall. Charming is a great word for it.
So that makes a real impact on price.
It's a great investment.
Baron Chu is like a lot of real estate brokers in Los Angeles.
And this is well over $600,000.
There's just one difference, though, between Chu and the others.
My nickname with my friends is the Subterranean Condo King.
Baron Chu is a cemetery plot broker, helping folks buy and sell space in LA's rapidly filling cemeteries.
Well, it is, in a sense, property. It's just smaller.
Small, but not cheap, with some family plots being listed at over $1 million.
Would those be the most expensive pieces of real estate in all of California?
Yeah, I would say so, wouldn't you? I mean, it's pretty high.
And it's real estate you don't even own once you've bought it. It still technically belongs to the cemetery. However, you do have the right to stay as long as you want.
The cemeteries own the grave, but you're buying the right for burial.
Other than that, cemetery real estate works a lot like other real estate.
It's location, location, location. People are looking for views. People are looking for peaceful sceneries. And, you know, believe it or not, we're so busy in Los Angeles, some of the busiest cemeteries in the world, that traffic in cemeteries can determine price as well.
Wait, so in LA, the traffic is so bad, there are traffic jams in the cemetery?
Absolutely. Yeah, it's crazy.
Oh, and one other major factor that drives prices, which celebrities are buried in the cemetery? This is, after all, Southern California.
There aren't that many cemeteries in LA. Right.
Baron Chu says he doesn't use dead celebrities as a selling point. He thinks it's disrespectful. But for fans of those celebrities, LA's cemeteries have always been a big draw.
We're all movie buffs. We like to come and visit the old movie stars.
Larry Trujillo makes the trip to L.A. from Albuquerque each year. The highlight? Visiting Marilyn Monroe.
We like to clean her gravestone up if it's dirty and put, you know, fresh flowers with fresh water in there.
John Roker and Lynn Williams came to Hollywood Forever Cemetery for Judy Garland.
She was in New York, and Liza took her and brought her back. But under one condition could she be here. That she could be as far away from Mickey Rooney as possible.
Garland was known to have carried a torch for Rooney, a feeling, alas, he did not share. Just another reason for Roker to invest in his little slice of eternity.
Oh, yeah. I got my plot when I was a kid.
Oh, really?
Smart thinking.
Yeah, because it ain't cheap these days.
No, it's not.
Not cheap at all.
In this cemetery, you are going to be close to all the rich and famous. And if you can't do it while you're living, might as well do it while you're dead.
Baron Chu showed me one of his properties. It's for sale for about $160,000, also in Hollywood Forever Cemetery.
Can I try this out?
Yeah, go ahead. Feel free.
So from about here down to here?
Yep.
Let me just...
And you know what they say, if the shoe fits. Mm.
I gotta say, it's very relaxing. All right, I'll take it.